Yo, what's good, Tristans?
And Tristfam!
Today, we're going to be reacting to Camila Cabello and Cinderella on Amazon. I've never done one of these videos before, but I'm so excited to do like an actual movie review. It's going to be so freaking fun! Now, this movie has been very controversial for a number of reasons and currently sits around 3 stars on Amazon with the reviews flooding in. There's some good things about it. There's a lot of bad things about it, but we're going to talk about it. But before we get started, be sure to check me out Instagram, TikTok, Patreon. This movie. So I had the pleasure / displeasure of watching this movie last night with some of my best friends. Shout out. This movie is one of the craziest, most... I don't even know what to say about this movie. We're going to be reacting to the movie, going through each one of the songs, and in each one of the songs, we're going to discuss it, the good things, the bad things. There's some great songs in this. There's also some songs with some very questionable vocal performances, and the songs themselves are also very questionable. But before we jump into that, y'all, I've got an Amazon affiliate link down in the description. And with that affiliate link, you can watch Cinderella yourselves. It's a free 30-day trial of Amazon Prime. With Amazon Prime, you can get free 2-day shipping. I use Amazon Prime every single freaking day of my life. Not only that, I got to watch Cinderella last night with my friends. I just screen shared it to them. We watched the movie. It was really, we're going to talk about that. There's also other great movies on here. My favorite series on here by far is got to be the Six-Headed Shark Attack series. They got Six-Headed Shark Attack. They got Four-Headed Shark Attack. Anyway, that's great. So anyway, if this movie looks interesting to you, and trust me, it is interesting. Please use my link down in that description below because you're going to get it for free. Okay, but great. I'm still giving my honest review of this piece of shit. Just kidding. It wasn't that bad. There are some very interesting twists and shocks and surprises in this movie. So let's just jump into it. We're going to go song by song throughout the entire thing. This movie, dude. All right, I'm excited.
Their world was about to change.
Oh my God, dude.
But until it did, y'all. Hardworking citizens moved to the same beat.
The fairy godmother in this movie is the best thing that has ever happened to Cinderella. I don't care how many people hate that I say that. Y'all gonna see exactly what I'm talking about when we get to that part. A lot of people did not like that though. Lots of 1-star reviews from this fairy.
Day after day.
I've got to say, all of these group numbers were not my favorite. Definitely not my favorite. Camila had some good songs in this. Not all of them, but she had some good songs.
Listen as your day unfolds. Challenge what the future holds. Try and keep your head up to the sky. Others, they may cause you tears. Go ahead, release your fears. Stand up and be counted. Cause you won't
she sounds pretty good
you
here.
Try. You gotta be bad. You gotta be bold. You gotta be wiser.
I'm not sure what was up with all these covers, though. The original music from this series I thought was actually pretty decent. But some of these covers, I don't know why they were in here. But Camila sounds pretty good.
You gotta be hard. You gotta be tough. You gotta be stronger. You gotta be cool, you gotta be calm,
there's the godmother.
Keep it together. All I know, love will save the day. Time asks no questions, it goes on without you. Leaving you behind if you can't stand the pain.
Occasionally, there's just like, you heard that auto-tune fragment there? Like, for the most part, the songs are pretty, well, it depends on the singer, but occasionally there's little auto-tune fragments, and I'm like, girl, you couldn't have re-recorded that, or they couldn't have touched it up or something, but whatever, no one's gonna notice that but me.
The best part is danger staring you in the face.
That was a cool run.
You gotta be bad, you gotta be bold, you gotta be wiser.
Oh my God.
Smash that fetamundo.
Take that, birds.
James Corden
Good
is
morning,
one of those mice. There's some parts where Camila's voice doesn't fit, but there's parts where it does fit, and it sounds so good, actually. This is her best solo song in the whole movie.
Here I go again. I'm imagining a world outside, unlike the one I'm in, daydreaming again of when I'll get a chance. There's a world that understands, where you don't hear the whispers in the room. You're walking in, daydreaming again. All I need is a chance.
I love her breathy vocals at the bottom of her range. When she does use them, I think it sounds so good. They're so full, and they have a reasonable amount of volume to them, so they sound strong at the same time.
When I feel my fear staring at me, I tell it just wait and see. I know who I'm gonna be, I know who I'm gonna be. The world's half asleep, it's gonna wake up and say.
Ooh, nice.
If it's a million to one, I'm gonna be that one. And if it's a shot in the dark, I'm gonna be the sun. And I just can't afford to be wrong. Even when I'm afraid, you're gonna know my name. Yeah, you're gonna know my name.
I feel like this is the strongest I've ever actually heard Camila's voice. She has all these big open sounds, probably in part because it's somewhat of a musical. I think in some ways the song doesn't exactly suit her vocal style, but I think her voice sounds better than I've heard it before. Clearly everything is produced and so on, but I like this.
The world's half asleep, it's gonna wake up and see.
I like the little bit of distortion she adds on her voice too. And clearly this isn't like a Disney singing style. It's very pop, very pop. But I like it. I don't mind it. I can see how some people wouldn't, though. If they're expecting Cinderella, but... Camila fans are gonna love this. I hope that she sings this live someday. This song actually sounds super hard to sing, so I'd love to hear her try it.
I'm gonna be the sun. I just can't afford to be wrong. Even when I'm afraid.
This duet with herself is kind of odd, but sounds good.
You're gonna know my name.
I'm waiting for the Prince scenes, dude. Oh no.
Hey, hear ye. I'm the new town crier. Yeah, I took over from Barry.
Oh no. This literally ruins the movie. They should have cut this out or done something different with this dude.
Like the way they play. Today we got news for you ladies and gents. A change in the guard is soon gonna commence.
It's like they're trying way too hard to be Hamilton and it does not work.
You will go to the ball, you will find someone. That's an order.
James Bond.
Now, go dress. I expect you to look sharp for the changing of the guard.
Oh man, This song, dude. No.
Can anybody?
No, please not again.
Find me.
Why?
Somebody to.
Each morning I get up, I die a little. Can barely stand on my feet.
His voice sounds pretty good sometimes. A lot of the times.
I have spent all my years in believing you, but I just can't get no relief. Lord, I work hard every day of my life. I work till I ache in my bones, but at the end of the day,
okay,
I'm all on my own. I get
okay, a little growl.
And I start to pray till the tears run down from my eyes.
A little bit of a rolled R, I guess.
Somebody, can anybody find me? Somebody love.
There's no way that was actually what was written. Why does he sing it like that?
It's just so strange the way he rolls that one R.
I mean, his voice is decent. It's just like sometimes I don't understand why they didn't re-record the phrase. And this happens frequently throughout the movie. There's like oddly a run or something that's just like very out of tune or just like not correct. And it's just, they just leave it in. I don't know why. Anybody find me? Why are they jumping around him? That me is just so not necessary, but whatever. That's not even a big deal. It's this run. Somebody love. That sounds great. That sounds amazing. What was that? The double voice crack? It's like, what is that? Otherwise, it usually sounds pretty good. This song is just too much. Everybody wants to put me down. They say I'm going crazy. Got nobody left to believe. Too many voice cracks. Sorry, but this is a bit much. He should have been Shawn Mendes.
Find me somebody to love. Find me somebody to love.
Find me somebody to love.
Find me somebody to love.
It just feels like blasphemy. Okay.
Get off my dad!
Shh. Oh, good. Everyone's staring at me, just as I'd hoped. I'm sorry, Your Highness.
Man, dude.
It's just really hard to see in the back. Might I suggest you put some bleachers back there? Give us short peasants a chance. I hereby decree all short peasants shall be pardoned by the king.
Get down now!
He doesn't. He didn't think that was funny, did he?
I don't think anybody did.
To love.
It was just too long without him singing, and it was like, oh, thank God he's done. And then suddenly he comes in a cappella with a sloppy run. It's like, why? Just do it again. It's fine though. It's not like it's not like it's bad or anything. It just sometimes the cringe is a little bit too much.
Unless, of course, it turns out that she's got a couple bats in the old belfry, in which case I will realize that my feelings were incorrect.
And slowly back away. It is your belfry that has bats.
I do not have a single bat in my belfry.
No, there are multiple bats in your belfry.
I am the prince, and I say that your belfry is the one with the bats.
Well, I'm the prince's best friend, and I say that yours is the one with the bats. I'm your best friend, right?
I have lots of friends.
What is... I don't know what's going on anymore.
Of course you're my best friend.
Yeah, I thought so.
Beautiful human.
It's like the only dialogue that they have in the entire movie. And I don't understand what they're even talking about. What is a belfry?
Act like
oh,
that.
Man. Some boys kiss me. Idina Menzel kills everything. One of her songs towards the end is actually really good, I think. I don't remember this one very well, though. But she always sounds good. Especially for how old is she? She sounds just as good as she did 10 years ago. The only thing that's a little bit odd to me is that Camila and Idina have two very, very distinctly different vocal styles. Normally, you wouldn't hear two different styles like that in the same show. So that's a little bit off-putting, and it kind of makes things not fit together so well. It feels like Camila has her songs, Idina has her songs, the prince has his songs, and they're not really cohesive. Idina, of course, being more of a pop sounding singer, Idina being more of a musical theater sounding singer, and the prince, you know,
singing. That's really one of the big complaints I have. But she sounds so good. I'm so happy she's in this. She saves it. A material world, and I am a
material girl. What about romance?
Oh, please.
Adina's voice is just more open.
Listen up.
Than Camila's is, which tends to be kind of tight and closed. A little bit of a growl there.
No way.
Only a voice who save their pennies make my rainy day. They are living in a material world, and I am a material girl.
But again, the weird cover songs that they put into this for no reason. I like hearing Adina singing, but just generally speaking, I don't understand why. I don't understand why. Why? There's an Ed Sheeran one, or there's two Ed Sheeran songs that come later, which are actually some of the better songs in the entire show. But I still don't understand why. But it's fun. I like it. It's like, it's interesting. What are they going to do next? I don't know. Nobody knows. I don't think the writers know.
Because everybody's living in a material world, and I am a material girl.
Because we are living in a material world.
Kills it, dude. And she also has noticeably less auto-tune in this performance than the previous performance has. It just makes the whole thing kind of disjointed in some ways, but I'm so appreciative for her performances.
I'll pay triple what you're asking.
You.
So Camila Cabello is like a dressmaker in this version. He's buying her dress.
Hey! Yeah!
Oh no.
Gather round, heed my cool. In 2 weeks, hence there'll be a bull. And not just any bull, this night could change your life. See, it's time the prince finally find his wife. That's right.
Alright, that's enough. It seems so out of place.
Am I wrong for thinking out the box from where I stay?
Another cover for some reason. I'm not complaining when she sings though.
For saying that I choose another way.
Oh, I ain't trying to do what everybody else doing, just cause everybody doing what they all do.
If one thing I know, how far would I go?
I don't know why he darkens his voice at the bottom. I'm just gonna leave him alone. No, I'm not. It would be okay if I'd heard him do that anytime before, but for some reason now randomly he's doing this. Oh, you're trying to do what everybody is doing. Why? Do it again. Redo the take. He sounds pretty decent there, though, to be real. Okay, I know Camila can hit whatever that run was supposed to be. So I don't know why that run is not... I'm getting triggered. Do it over! Why don't they have her do it again? Why did they leave that in the final production? Those of y'all who are getting a little bit put off by this movie, let me tell you this straight up. As soon as the fabulous godmother makes their presence known in this movie, the movie gets way better. It gets a little bit slow in this section, and with the Queen song, and Adina kind of picks it back up, and then this ruined this whole song for me. I'm sorry, it just did. But it gets way better in the second half. So her mother or stepmother, I don't remember, doesn't let her go to the ball. Y'all know Cinderella, right? She's sad.
When I feel my fear staring at me, I tell it just wait and see. I know who I'm gonna be, I know who I'm gonna. The world's half asleep, it's gonna wake up and say.
This is good. See, she's killing it.
You're gonna know my name. You're gonna know my.
I like these. I like when she sings this song. It sounds real. It's good. It's so weird. There's so many ups and downs in this movie.
Well done.
It's like
friend.
A roller coaster. Oh, here we go. Yes. This is literally the best part of the movie.
Yes! Now this is how you make an entrance!
This is the only time in the movie it feels like a real movie.
I am your fabulous godmother.
But why?
Baby, you saved me. And so now I'm here to save you by sending you to that ball. When you wish
upon a star. He's one of the best singers in this whole dang thing. It's so sad this is his only song. Oh, yeah. When you wish upon a dream. Hey, hey. Oh, life ain't always what it seems. Shine and star come in. But a lot of people were very upset by the idea of a male playing the godmother. Very upset. It's actually hilarious to me how mad people got about this. It's crazy to me how people are upset about the gender of a fairy. It's a fairy. It's not real. It's not real. Not only that, but he's one of the best things in the whole show. His voice is amazing.
What?
Make your body big and strong. He darkens his voice at the bottom of his range so naturally, too. Unlike the prince.
Indoctrination of homosexuality to children. You have a drag queen as the fairy godmother. Glad I watched this when my kid was sleeping. Would have so many questions about the fairy drag queen mother. Why did I watch it till the end, alone in my closet at night? And why did I keep watching the fairy scene over and over and over again?
Oh my god.
As a kid, I watched and read most of the fairy tales. Not one had a fairy homosexual. Stop shoving homosexuality down my throat, Amazon.
I think the only person shoving homosexuality down your throat is yourself there, sir. All these fairy experts, dude.
That's not what fairies are like at all. I know everything about fairies, and let me tell you, they're nothing like that one.
But okay, I'm telling you guys, these reviews are better than the actual movie, so we're going to react to those at the end. Let's get back into it.
Did I miss?
Wait for a shining star for you to see what your life can truly be. Shining star for you to see what your life can truly be.
No autotune on his voice at all.
What you can truly.
And by the way, E is like the hardest vowel to sing high, and he completely killed it.
This is gorgeous!
Yes, future queen, yes!
What's that, Prince?
You're a shining star, no matter who you are. Shining bright to see what you could truly be.
They sound so good together. Why isn't it longer is the only issue. You know what I honestly think it is? I think the producers of the movie knew that this would be controversial and they didn't want to do too much of it. But that is so much better than the Prince's songs. And she does some duets with the Prince later on and they're half decent, but that was just really good. It should have been longer. That should have been a whole song.
The fudge.
You need footmen.
Oh no. James Corden.
He sees us.
Well. It's just so weird is this rat. I don't know why.
Creatures. Whoa.
Where's my tail? I can't balance without my tail.
This is the last we ever see of the fabulous godmother.
You're a shining. You're a shining.
Voice is unreal. I need to hear more of him singing live. His voice is actually unreal.
Oh no.
And then into another one of these weird covers, but okay.
I want to take a minute or two and give much respect due to the man that's made a difference in my world.
And although most men are hoes, he flows on the down low, cause I never heard about him with another girl.
Oh no, I forgot. I forgot where this goes. No, no, why?
I'm gonna fight him off. A Seven Nation Army couldn't hold me back. They're gonna
why this song? It doesn't sound
taking
bad though.
Their time right behind my back. And I'm talking to myself at night because I can't forget. Oh, back and forth through my mind like a minuet.
Actual time signature change there.
So leave it alone.
There's no way anybody likes this more than the last song. There's no way. I don't think that's how that works. This movie is so ridiculous. This is good. I think the only one of the only covers that actually fits.
For me, darling, just dive right in and follow my lead.
Well, I found a boy.
I never knew you were the someone waiting for me. I see my future in your eyes, baby.
His voice sounds better to me when it sings. He sings softer. This is a really sweet duet, I think. If only it was Sean, though, right? Key change, okay.
With you between my arms, barefoot on the grass, you look perfect.
This is actually good. The new take on the song is really sweet.
Perfect.
The harmonies were good. They turned it into a duet. That's really pretty. Their voices actually went well together because they both sort of calmed down a little bit. Vocally,
I found a boy.
Camille is actually surprisingly a really good actress throughout this entire thing. I was pretty shocked by that actually. It was hard to get into at first because I just saw her as Camille, but as it went on, I was kind of surprised that she's actually a pretty decent actress. Not everyone in this movie is a good actor though, but she was surprisingly really good. They have some good actors in this though. Dialogue is just strange.
Fuck up, guys!
I could have happily gone the rest of my life without ever seeing this image. I don't know what to say about this. This song is killer.
Fine.
This song is killer.
Then I'm taking you to Thomas, and I'm giving you to him
today.
I would rather die.
All right, Camila's being a little bit of a baby over there.
This is life. It's not fair. It's not right. All that hope and that pride, it's a waste. It's a lie.
This is a perfect song for her. So good.
One is to breathe. Little girl should run free. But your course is too tight. And your heels are too high. The treasure you found, bury it. The only
dude
need another dream girl.
This is perfectly written for her.
Another dream girl. Don't be sentimental. Some legends are born in the wrong time.
She's almost like rocking out here, dude.
The only way I'll marry it. The shadow of time. Carry it. Carry it down to your grave. Bury it.
Not to be rude, but I just wanted to hear Adina here. I don't care about the rest of these people. That's so pretty, though. These harmonies. It makes me wish they did more of that. That's the other thing that's strange, is just all the songs just don't tie together or connect in any way. Like, I suppose this is a musical. I'm not sure what this movie is, but like in really good musicals, the songs tie together. They wrap up in a certain way. There's like themes that go throughout all the songs that connect everything, and it's cohesive. But this just is not cohesive. It just seems like they slapped together a bunch of random songs. Yeah, that's really, that probably is exactly what they did. I'm not sure if it's just me, but this is one of the strangest kissing scenes I've ever seen. Something just ain't right over there.
That's what you said. And you know what? What was that?
Camila.
Go.
Numbskull.
Nope, 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 nope. Okay, we're almost done.
Let's get loud. Let's get loud. Turn the music up.
This is randomly a Latin song in here now.
Yes, let's get loud. Turn the music up
to hear that sound. Camila sounds great in it, though, of course. I don't know how I feel about this ending of the movie, but whatever.
And so we've reached the end of this fairy tale.
Yes, we have. So yeah, that was definitely an interesting movie. I think if I had to review it on a purely basis of quality out of 5 stars, I would give it a 2 out of 5 stars in quality. It's not a good movie. But in terms of entertainment value, I'm gonna have to give that 4.5 out of 5. Stars. It's just too good. The cohesiveness of the movie itself is like, it's all over the place. It's wild. The dialogue is not great. There's some really good songs in it, but for the average person, I don't know how much they care about that, because the way that the songs are like introduced or put into the movie is a little bit much sometimes and like random. Like, why is the prince singing Queen? Like, it's just, it's too disjointed and confusing, and the genres and styles are all so different that I can see it just being very jarring for adults. Maybe it might be a fun movie for kids. I don't know. But in terms of just how fun it is to like watch the whole thing and how ridiculous it is, I had a lot of fun watching this movie. And it has lots of really good songs in it, even if they're like a little bit weird and abrupt and they don't fit exactly. If you can find a way to appreciate them for what they are, you know, pretty good. So we're gonna check out some of these reviews because they're really funny. But before we do that, again, link down in the description if you're interested in checking this out for free. Use my link. All my videos get copyright claims, so it really helps out. But let's check out some of these reviews because they are actually hilarious. We'll close off this with some of these amazing reviews. The thing is, I don't know if this deserves 3 stars. I don't know, because I found it very entertaining. But the thing is, a lot of the reviews, I'm pretty sure didn't even watch the movie. They're just mad about the fairy. Somehow they found out that the fairy in the movie was male instead of female, and it just angered them immensely. Too bad they didn't show this to Biden before the withdrawal. It might have changed his mind about the women of Afghanistan. And don't even get me started about the fairy godmother. I'm not sure what that has to do with the movie, but okay. Here's the Karen of the comments. I was looking forward to watching this movie, but it was overshadowed by the politically correct woke movement. Everything from a gay fairy godmother, groomsmen in woman's nails. I didn't notice that, by the way. Princesses talking about turning wind into electricity. Really? That's the thing that makes you mad? The wind into electricity? That doesn't even have anything to do with being woke. And non-binary titles. I don't think there were any. The only reason I gave it 1 star was the fairy godmother and the gospel. What is wrong with the gospel? I don't even think there was any gospel in this, to be real. Okay, fine. Some people don't like gospel. Another perverse movie. The fairy godmother is a gay black man. Not good for kids. Ooh. Ooh.
I would give this negative 10 stars if I could. I don't understand the need to make the fairy godmother a gay dude.
As far as I know, we didn't see the fabulous godmother, excuse you, do anything actually gay, so...
Not necessary, and only done to normalize homosexuals to your kids. I won't let my kids see this. Only I can watch it alone.
The movie is literally about a straight relationship.
Can't get past the trailer. 1 star. I'm only reviewing this to be sure the stars reflect to the viewers how sadly this film missed the mark.
And I gave it 1 star for normalizing mice to young, innocent kittens.
But yeah, anyway, it definitely wasn't a very good movie. I think some of the negative reviews are obviously somewhat exaggerated, but it was fun. But anyway, hopefully you guys enjoyed my video. I had a lot of fun making it. I had a lot of fun watching the movie. If you did enjoy it, be sure to check me out. Instagram, TikTok, and also Patreon if you're interested in supporting me over there. I appreciate all my patrons so much. Y'all are so beautiful. Check out that link down in the description if you're interested in watching this movie for free.
Just be sure to cancel your subscription before the trial ends.
Peace, you guys.